The Origins of Masks. Let's travel to Greece. Masks were significant elements in the worship of Dionysus, the god of revelry and fertility. In Athens, Greeks likely used masks in ceremonial rites and celebrations. Most of the evidence of the use of masks come from a few vase paintings dated from the 5th century BC. No physical evidence remains available to us, as the masks were made of organic materials such as wood, cloth, or leather. Many of the masks were decorated with hair, either human or animal, to complete the effect. The actors were only able to see through the small holes that were drilled where the pupil of the eye would be. The mouth opening was formed out like a megaphone, making some theorists believe the masks helped to accentuate the actor's voice. But there are others that discount this concept. In a large open-air theater, like the Theater of Dionysus in Athens, the classical masks were able to bring characters' face closer to the audience, especially since they had intensely over-exaggerated facial features and expressions. They enabled an actor to appear and reappear in several different roles, thus preventing the audience from identifying the actor to a specific character. Their variations helped the audience distinguish sex, age, social status, in addition to revealing a change in particular character's appearance. Actors still use masks today in their productions of Greek theater, holding to the traditions of their thespian forefathers.
Let's travel to Egypt. From the Middle Kingdom to the 1st century AD, the ancient Egyptians placed stylized masks with generalized features on the faces of their dead. The funerary mask served to guide the spirit of the deceased back to its final resting place in the body. These masks were made of cloth covered with stucco or plaster, which was then painted. For more important personages, silver and gold were used. Among the most splendid examples of the burial portrait mask is the one created for the pharaoh Tutankhamun.
Let's travel to Africa. African masks are used both ceremonially and ritually. They are mostly found in sub-Saharan and West Africa. The specific use of the masks vary widely from culture to culture. Most masks are used for spiritual and religious purposes and are used in ritual dances and social and religious events. Both the maker of the mask and the wearer of the mask hold a high status within the community. In most traditional African cultures, the person who wears a ritual mask conceptually loses his or her human identity and turns into the spirit represented by the mask itself. Most masks are made of wood, although a wide variety of other elements can be used, including some metals like copper and bronze. The mask can then be adorned with a wide variety of ornamental items such as animal hair, horns, teeth, seashells, and feathers.
Let's travel home.
Festival masks are still commonly used today for a lot of the same reasons that masks have been used in the past. These characteristics were used for hiding, creating personalities, revealing moods, and for spiritual rituals. Masks are seen and used to celebrate Halloween with absurd and grotesque faces. They are made of plastic with fake hair and fake blood. Mardi Gras has very colorful masks made up of gold, green, and purple. They are used in parades and parties to conceal one's identity to be able to have a fun, crazy time. Masked balls emphasized formal dancing with masks that were very beautiful, made up of paper, plastic, jewels, glitter, and feathers. So the next time you put on a mask, think about the meaning behind it. Now it's time for you to make your mark on history. Create your own mask. Significant historical elements and geographic origins should be reflected in your mask. You will also need to provide a list of techniques and mediums you use to create your mask. Original creativity while making your mask will be its most important quality.